Another day closer to the weekend. Good morning. It's your home for worship and the word, K-Wave 107.9. Good morning. I'm Bob Shaw. Getting closer to the fall season again. So as you grab your pumpkin spice latte, which is way overpriced, let's come together live for spiritual caffeine. All right. Get you going this morning in the right direction with encouragement and prayer. If you have access to our Facebook page or YouTube channel, you can watch us as we stream live. Let's welcome Pastor David Trujillo from Calvary Chapel, South LA. Good morning, Pastor. It's been a while. Good to see you.
Good to see you, my brother. Everything's good. How's things over there?
Things are as well as can be, my friend. God is good. Awesome. God is good.
Yes, he is.
Kind of encouragement do you have for us this morning?
Well, I want to just share a little bit about turning persecution to production. And I'm reading out of Acts chapter 16, verse 25. And this is what it reads. It says, "But at midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the prisoners were listening to them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's chains were loosed. And the keeper of the prison, on waking from sleep and seeing the prison doors open, supposing the prisoners have fled, drew the sword and was about to kill himself. But Paul called with a loud voice, saying, 'Do yourself no harm, for we are all here.'" You see, Paul and Silas were actually beaten in Philippi and also thrown into prison simply for preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. And one of the things that I want you guys to notice is that instead of being bitter of the situation, they use the situation to become better, because we do know that persecution builds the character. But one of the things that I want you to note is that instead of pouting, they were praising. Instead of whining, they were worshiping. And the reason why they were able to do that is because they fully understood that God was in control. He's sovereign. And he knew that all things were going to work together for good. I mean, he writes that for those who love the Lord. And especially in times like this, where the world looks dark and it seems like the world now has made it is number one goal to persecute the church, you know, we have an opportunity to be salt. We have an opportunity to be light. But we need to understand that the enemy is going to play alongside of us, trying to inflict fear to cripple us from doing the work of God. My thing is this. Listen, well, not my thing. What the scripture teaches is that if we trust in the Lord and we believe the Lord, and we remain faithful to his word, God is going to accomplish what he wants to do through us. Don't let the enemy scare you into quietness, but let God's faith, not faith, his strength, move you to boldness. Because if you remember in the story, the Philippian jailer came to a saving knowledge of the Lord. And what I like about Paul is this. He didn't pray, "God, get me out," right? He was praying. And in his prayer and in his worship, I'm sure that the Philippian jailer was listening. So when he realized, right before he was going to take his life, and Paul called down and says, "Hey, don't do yourself no harm." At that moment, he asked the question. Have you noticed that? He says, "What must I do to be saved?" So that means that he was paying attention. He was watching, right, the Apostle Paul and Silas in that prison cell. And when opportunity came for them to minister, Paul was in the right place. Because think about it. The earthquake was there. He could have ran off, but he didn't. He remained, and God used them to bring that person to a saving knowledge of the Lord. So people are watching, yeah, right? People are observing this, especially in dark times. When you remain faithful, you can be assured that you can be a means for God to get his word across to the people that he's trying to reach with his love.
Amen to that, man. I love that. I want to talk to you more about this, because I want you to show how it applies to people today and things that are going on today. So can you pray for us, and then we'll do that?
Yes, let's pray. And Heavenly Father, we just come before you and we thank you, Lord, for just being our God, that you give us that confidence in you, Lord, to be able to come to this world, to be in this world, and to be the light. Father, help us not to shy away. Help us not to be afraid, but to be men and women of faith, that we're not going to back down. We're not going to shut up, Lord, until you take us up, God. And we're praying, Father, for your spirit to fall afresh upon us, to empower us, Lord, so that we may remain faithful and so that you can use us as a means to bring the saving message of the gospel to those, Lord God, that need you. Again, we thank you, Father, for this morning. Go before us. In Jesus' name we say, amen.
Amen. Thanks so much, Pastor. The bummer is we don't have time for more of this on K-Wave, but the good news is we have all the time in the world to continue our conversation on our Facebook page and YouTube channel. So please connect with us there as Pastor David Trujillo and I break down Acts 16:25. Here on K-Wave, Pastor Greg Laurie shows us how we can learn to be world changers. That's next on A New Beginning. So, Pastor, I don't know about you, but being around bitter people sucks all the energy out of me. I've been there. I've been that bitter person. And thank goodness I have gotten out of that, because once you're in that kind of state of mind, it's a downward spiral, man. You cannot see past beyond your own problems and your own issues, and you're doing nothing good for God.
Amen. Amen. And you're right. You know, I take my example from Jesus himself. Remember, he was our Lord, of course, but remember everything that he went through. Remember, he was persecuted, he was mocked, he was ridiculed. And one of the things that blesses my heart, if you remember with me, that when Jesus was on that cross, he was praying for those that were doing these things. He said, forgive them, for they know not what they do. If you fast forward through the scriptures, there's a passage in the book of Hebrews where it talks about, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. And I strongly believe that as believers, as God begins to develop our mindset, it also affects our attitude and how we approach certain situations, we'll be able to be like the Lord in a sense of enduring for the joy that is set before us. And what greater joy is to be able to endure affliction, persecution, or whatever it might be, but to see that person come to a saving knowledge of the Lord, there's no word to express the joy in our hearts. Yeah. To be an instrument in God's hands to snatch a soul from Satan's grip and place them in the arms of our loving God.
So let's apply this to what's going on today. Obviously, this whole COVID thing has been dragging on for almost 6 months now. Easy to get bitter, especially maybe if you've been laid off. You didn't see this coming back in January. All of a sudden, here you are between jobs, or maybe someone has just done you wrong to the point where you can't even see beyond it. I mean, there's any number of different things that could cause you to become a bitter person. And instead, we want to be better people. So what do you say to people like that?
Take your minds off the situation and put it back on the Lord. You know, Paul and Silas were in a tough situation. Remember, they were beaten with clubs, right? They were locked up in these stocks where their their feet were locked up. They were unable to move. They were uncomfortable. And if you notice in the passage, they were praying and praising at midnight, which gives us some insight to the fact that they probably couldn't sleep of the pain, maybe. Whatever it was, they were awake at midnight. But they were praising and worshiping God. Job had almost the same thing. He went through some hard time. And what did he do? He shaved his head. Now, don't shave your head now, right? But he started praising the Lord. So what I would encourage everyone to do is in this time right now, you can allow the enemy to use it to make you bitter, or you can take this opportunity to draw closer to the Lord through your worship and through your praying, and come out of the situation a better Christian or a stronger Christian. Yeah. See, so take this opportunity and allow God to work in you, that He can prepare you to work through you in this world.
Worship and prayer, wonderful. And I would even add to that, your actions. Find something to get outside of your problems and help other people. There's nothing better to boost your spirits than helping people. And helping people that are going maybe through the same thing you are. And instead of being bitter together and commiserating and being all, you know, all crotchety about the whole thing, lift each other up. Pray.
Yes.
You know, get involved in the Word. Find a group. You know, do something that's going to make you a better person.
Get active, you know, see what the church is doing. I know for us this Friday, we'll be going out to the streets, you know, with a blowhorn and just preach the gospel. And I've been inviting the church, listen, bring your signs. Let's stand right here, man. Let's let people know that God loves them.
That's so great.
You're right, getting outside of your own little walls there and going out to the street along with your brothers and sisters. Because remember, in Hebrews, we're told as well not to forsake the assembling, but we're to encourage one another, stirring each other up for good works. Yeah. And that's where you're going to find joy, doing the work of the Lord.
Amen. Pastor David Trujillo of Calvary Chapel, South LA. Find out more at ccsola.org. Pastor, don't be such a stranger. Come back soon. And we want to hear from you again. So thanks for coming together with us this morning.
Thank you, my friend. God bless you, bro.
God bless you. Thanks for coming in. Join us tomorrow morning again around 8:25. We have more devotions and prayer. Pastor Bill Buffington from Calvary Chapel Inglewood will be joining me in the Calvary Chapel Costa Mesa parking lot as we do the grocery distribution and giving us a little encouragement. Right now on K-Wave, join Pastor Greg Laurie and A New Beginning. Until tomorrow morning, K-Wave family, God bless you. Step outside your own problems. Help those in need.